Welcome friends and welcome to my series of video lectures on theory of structures. In continuation with the topic of simple trusses, in today's video lecture we are going to solve a numerical problem on method of sections for a cantilever frame. We are studying the topic of simple trusses in relation with the course outcome F. Evaluate axial forces in members of simple trusses. In today's video lecture, we are going to learn the method of finding member forces by method of sections. So, we will solve a numerical problem on this. So, the problem is calculate member forces in a given frame. So, this is the frame A, B, C, D, E. You can see that this is a cantilever frame. That means it is supported only on one side by a fixed support and the other entire frame is projecting out without any support outside. So, this is a cantilever type of frame. Now, the method of solving the problem for method of sections and method of joints, the steps are the same. The first step is calculation of support reactions. Now, as in method of joints, in this case also, a cantilever frame will not require a calculation of support reactions. You can solve the problem without calculating the support reactions. You will require support reactions only if your frame is not a cantilever frame. That means if it is a simply supported frame. So step 1 stands already over. Now we go to step 2. The step 2 is member forces by method of sections. Here we need to get introduced to this method of sections a little bit. We have solved some problems using method of joints. In method of joints, we were isolating an individual joint and considering its free body diagram and finding out the member forces by equilibrium equations. In method of section, instead of isolating individual joint, we are cutting the frame along some imaginary line. We imagine that the frame is cut along an imaginary line so that the frame is broken into a left part and a right part. So we will consider the equilibrium of either the right part or the left part, apply the equilibrium equations to that entire part of frame and find out the unknown forces. So that is similar but little different than the method of joints. Now, while deciding where to cut the frame, you have to apply one important condition. That condition is that you have to draw the imaginary line of cutting the frame in such a way that you cut maximum 3 unknown member numbers. So you can cut 3 members maximum so that while solving the equations you have got only 3 unknowns. Just as you had in method of joints only 2 members should get cut unknown forces, here the condition is that there should be maximum 3 unknown forces. So let us start solving this problem by an actual example. So now let us imagine that we want to cut this frame along this line. If we imagine this line, then we can say that this ED, EA and BA, 3 members will get this, this and this. 3 members will get cut. So this satisfies the condition which I told right now. So let us draw a cutting line. And we will call that line as MM. MM. So, if we imagine that the frame is cut along MM, these 3 members will get cut and we will get a left portion of the frame and a right portion of the frame separate. So, I have shown here the right portion of the frame. Here is the line MM and 1, 2, 3 members have got cut. The entire remaining frame is as it is, 5 kN, 6 kN, 4 meter, E, B, C, all the things are here. The remaining frame is not shown. Now, because the entire frame was in equilibrium, every part of the frame also must be in equilibrium. That is why we can apply the conditions of equilibrium to this frame, this entire frame. Now, before we start applying the conditions of equilibrium, let us look at the cut members. This is ED. We know there is D on this side. So, the direction of ED is not known. We don't know the direction of ED. So, we will as usual assume the direction to be
away from the joint at which it is acting. So this is FED. This is also assumed away. So this is FEA. And this is also assumed to be acting to away from the joint B. And this is FBA.
So we have got three forces cut. So this is now a complete free body diagram of this right side part of the frame. Now you can see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 forces. 3 internal forces and 2 external forces. So this part is consisting of 5 forces in all. Now these forces are not passing through a single point. So they are not concurrent. They were concurrent in case of method of joints. But in the method of sections, the forces are not concurrent. And when the forces are not concurrent, we can apply 3 conditions of equilibrium instead of 2. We have got 3 equations, sigma m equal to 0, sigma fx equal to 0 and sigma y equal to 0. It is our choice which condition should we apply first. So in this problem, let us apply the condition of sigma m equal to 0. Sigma m equal to, now whenever we say sigma m, it means algebraic sum of moments. You should also immediately mention the moment point. So at which point you are taking all these moments. So we have to decide the moment point. You may take B, you may take C, you may take E. So which point is convenient to consider? If you look here, this FED and FEA, two unknown forces are passing through point E itself. And one unknown force is acting away from it. So if we take moments about point E, both of these forces, they are passing through E, so their moments about E will be 0. And in the equation, we will have only one unknown, FBA. So it is convenient to consider point E as moment point. So ME equal to 0. So this is how we will apply. Now we will have to write down the moment equation. So we have to be careful while writing the moment, while taking the moments. Look at all the forces. There are 5 forces. First force, 0 moment because it is directly passing through E. Second force, FEA passing through E. So its moment about E itself is 0. Then the next force is FBA. Look at FBA. It is passing. It is like this. And its distance from point E, perpendicular distance, is 3 meters. So it is 3 meters distance from E, perpendicular distance. So its moment is going to be 3 into FBA. So we get 3 into FBA. Now look at the sense. The arrow tip is like this and E point is here. So this force will rotate in clockwise sense about point E. So this will be 0. This will be plus. So this is plus 3 FBA. Now, moment of this 5 kN force, if you see, if you extend this 5 kN force, it will pass through point E. So its moment about E will be again 0. Then we look at 6 kN force. This 6 kN force, if it is extended perpendicular from E on this force, will be of length 4 meters. So if you extend this 6 kN, E will be at a distance, perpendicular distance of 4 meter from E. So we will get, and that sense will also be positive. Because if you look at 6 kN arrow tip, so with respect to E, this will rotate again in clockwise direction. We are getting clockwise moments positive. So this will give us 6 into 4. 6 forces, 6 meters and 4 meters. So this will be equal to 0. All the forces, 5 forces are considered. So if you look at this equation will give us FBA equal to minus 8 kN. FBA equal to minus 8 kN. What is the meaning of minus sign? Again the same. FBA is this. So it is direction is shown away from the section the joint B. So it will should be shown towards joint B. So we can show it here.
And similarly counterpart will be shown here. So this is 8. Answer is 8.
So this point is over. Now we will go to the next condition. So sigma Fy equal to 0. We know that we have got three conditions, sigma M, sigma Fx and sigma Fy. Now I will say sigma Fy equal to 0. So now look at all the forces again. We have to consider y components of all the five forces. FED is already in x direction, so no y component. FEA, this force has got a y and x component both. Now for that, first of all, you have to calculate this angle alpha. This angle alpha. Angle alpha is going to be tan inverse of, you can see, alpha is going to be tan inverse of 5 upon 3. So, at alpha angle is going to be 59.04 degrees. So, this is angle alpha. So, let us go with this. So, what is the y component of FEA? It is going to be FEA cos alpha. And it will act downwards, so it will be treated as minus because the upward forces will be treated positive. So this is over, this is over. This force FBA is already in x direction, no y component. 5 kN force, it is minus 5 acting downwards. And that 6 kN force, it is also acting downwards, so it is minus 6. So this is equal to 0. So this will give us, you know that FEA cos FEA is the only unknown force. So this will give us FEA equal to minus 21 point 38 kN. Minus 21.38 kN. Again, this is FEA, so this inclined force, so its direction should be reversed. The direction assumed is away from the joint E, it should be reversed, it should go towards the joint E. So here we will show it like this. And its value is 21.38. So, this is the second thing we get. Now the third condition, first condition applied, second applied, the third condition is sigma Fx equal to 0 with rightward forces positive. So, again look at all the five forces and take their x components. FED is in x direction and it is leftwards, so it is minus FED. That FEA is inclined, so it will have a x component, so it will be FEA sine alpha and its sine will be again minus. Then FBA is already along the y along x direction. Now you have to, if it is, you have to take it like this, minus 8. Minus minus 8. Because we know that FBA has come out to be minus 8 if it is in this direction. Then 5 kN and 6 kN are in y direction, so though they don't have any x components. Right? So in this we put this value of FEA as minus 21.38 so that we get FED directly from this. So we have to equate this to 0
and this gives us F ED equal to, so this comes out to be 26.33 plus 26.33. Since the sign is plus, it means that assumed direction of FED is correct. That means it is really acting away from the joint. So the arrow tip will come away from the joint E. Same is the case here. And the value is 26.33. Now we can transfer these values in the table. First is FBA minus 8. So this is 8. We will not take cognizance of that minus sign here. We will be assigning tension or compression. Look at BA. So this BA member has got both the arrows away from each other. So this is compression. Second is EA or AE. It is 21.38. And arrows are away, so C, compression. And the last one is DE is 26.33, and this gives tension because the arrow tips are pointing towards each other. So in this way we have got the values of three unknown member forces in just one section. You have cut it only once and applied conditions of equilibrium. We have got three answers. So as compared with method of joints, you find that this method seems to be little more efficient, but it involves a little bit more calculations also. So friends, that is a problem on method of sections. We will be continuing the same problem in the next video. So goodbye till the next video.